नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज द कॉल्पिट्स ओसिलेटर. दिस इज वन ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ योर टाइप्स ऑफ ओसिलेटर. बाय दिस वन बी प्रोड्यूसिंग अ ओसिलेशंस यू ऑब्जर्व दिस सर्किट फर्स्ट. दिस इज योर कॉमन एमिटर ट्रांजिस्टर. ऑब्जर्व दिस वन, दिस इज योर कॉमन एमिटर ट्रांजिस्टर. देयर इज द बायसिंग कंपोनेंट आर वन आर टू एंड आर थ्री RE, and bypass capacitor is the CE, emitter bypass capacitor, and next one is the coupling capacitor, second one is the coupling capacitor CC2, and here main focus, this is also common as a you're in a Hartley oscillator. Now compared with Hartley and Colpitts, we observe this one, the Hartley we use a two inductor, here Colpitts use a two capacitor. Means Hartley use a two inductor L1 and L2 and one of the capacitor. Here to observe this one, here use a two capacitor C1 and C2, this one and this one, and one of the inductor, means just opposite of this one. Here L1 and L2 in a Hartley same place we use a capacitor, and the in the capacitor place we use an inductor. This is the comparison of your Hartley and Colpitts. Now to observe this one, this is as a oscillatory circuit. This consider here, not output is considered here. This is your oscillatory circuit, also called a tank circuit. This section is your oscillatory circuit or tank circuit. Now by producing this oscillatory circuit, oscillation what is your produce and amplify your transistor, and output is obtained here the collector, again next to feedback connection through your oscillatory circuit. This is the overall conclusion of working of this Colpitts oscillator. Here first, how particular oscillation of particular frequencies produces, first focus this one. Means we have already seen f is equal to particular frequency producing by your oscillator is the relation of 2 pi under root L multiplied by C. This is the relation. Now to observe this circuit, tank circuit or oscillatory circuit, this C has two C1 and C2 and one of the inductor. Means inductor is the same we put up here in the relation, and C is here the series combination of C1 and C2. Now the series combination of C1 C2 is formed as a, how to calculate the series combination, this is the calculated by this one, we observe this one relation, means series combination of this one relation are we use, means the resonant frequency, sorry resonance not oscillator oscillations frequency is, now the relation is the 1 upon 2 pi L multiplied CT, T means total capacitance. Now CT is the, this is the series combination of relation, that's why the relation I have used this one. This is the particular frequency of oscillation is produced by this circuit of your Colpitts oscillator. These are the particular frequency oscillated by your Colpitts oscillator. This is the circuit description. To observe this one, the first we focus the operation. This is the circuit description is explained here. This is also written all the points whatever I say. This also written here. One of the difference is the difference is the only difference is that in case of Colpitts oscillator, coupling is used is a capacitive. The coupling is a capacitive, where in a Hartley oscillator the coupling is a inductive. One of the differences, major differences written here, Hartley and Colpitts, means coupling is a capacitive. This is your Colpitts, and in a Hartley there is a inductive coupling. This is one of the form is the capacitive coupling, and in the Hartley in this place is inductive coupling. Now focus your operation in similar way. Operation is also like your Hartley. To observe this one, first be switch on your DC supply and capacitor C1 C2 start charging, and discharging path follow your inductor. This is written here. Means first be on your VCC supply and then capacitor is charging C1 and C2 and discharge path is follows L. And by this one, the tank circuit means C1, C2 and L now producing a particular of oscillations. Now this whatever the oscillation is now producing, now next to move, this oscillation is feed to your transistor in a base, or we use word as a apply in a your transistor input. Means whatever the oscillation produced by your oscillator circuit, now this one feed to your transistor in a base by using through this capacitor. Means now this connection is goes to this one terminal. Now this is now base terminal is connected to this C1. Now to feed this transistor, whatever the oscillation now producing, feed to your transistor. Now transistor what he did, he amplified your oscillation and obtain the output across your collector. Means collector is now feedback connection through follow and apply your oscillator circuit. Means if there is losses when the oscillation is producing, the losses is happen in your circuit, the losses is now compensated by your amplified output is obtained here the collector, and collector is some energy, means fraction of energy now feedback to your oscillatory circuit. That's why there is a sustained oscillation be obtained. Also observe the phase shift in reference to your phase shift. The reference of phase shift we also observe here, means this terminal of A and B is produces a 180 degree phase shift. Next common emitter is transistor is now produces the 180 degree, means total phase shift is a 360, means there is a positive feedback. That's why there is a sustained oscillation produced by your Colpitts oscillator. This also written all the points whatever I explain here. Oscillator is produced by your circuit C1 and C2 and L. This is the oscillatory circuit C1, C2 and L. Next is the applied to your base of your transistor through C1. Thus the C1 is written here, means through C1 by this capacitor we apply your in a base of your transistor. This one connection follow. And next written, now it is applied your apply your transistor. Okay. Next this is amplified output. This is the same frequency that of oscillatory circuit applied amplified output feed to your oscillatory circuit. Whatever I explain means after the oscillation is produced by this tank circuit and feed to your transistor of base, and this is now amplified and amplified by your transistor, the amplified output is come across your collector. Now collector is connected through your oscillatory circuit, means whatever the loss is now compensated by your output of your transistor in a oscillatory circuit. This also written in by this one we obtain a sustained oscillation with respect to your phase shift. We see here the circuit point A and B 180 degree phase shift already I explained, means further 180 degree shift is produced by your common emitter transistor, means total phase shift is the 360. This is ensure that the positive feedback present, means when there is a, we have already explained the, if there is a amplifier, now the amplifier output is obtained, now there is a feedback through circuit obtained in the input side same phase, means total phase shift is obtained 360 or a 0 degree, then there is a positive feedback in present, means this circuit work as a oscillator. This is the explained here, means total 360 degree. This oscillatory circuit is continuous getting energy from the collector circuit to ensure your sustained oscillation. Also written here sustained oscillation in the to ensure your sustained oscillation. Next point here. Okay, this one of your Colpitts oscillator. B next focus your phase shift oscillator, and next go your phase shift oscillator is a generally used RC phase shift oscillator. Next we focus your Wien-Wiese oscillator.